Let me start by saying once again, the teams we played have been very, very good and well coached, and this one was no different. I have the utmost respect for Coach Bartow. We've been buddies a long time, but aside from that, he's a fantastic coach, and his team is really, really good. They're disciplined, they're tough. Now, with that being said, I thought our guys did a nice job tonight of withstanding their runs. Every time they made a big bucket or what could have been a deflating three-pointer, our guys kept their head up and kept grinding and went to the other end, executed, scored ourselves, or got stops back at the other end when it was needed. I know a lot of you might say, well, you know, the way you play, you give up a lot of threes, and they made 13, and that is a lot. But our system and our style of play, when you make a team shoot 32 of their 48 balls from behind the line, they're going to make some. But the advantage of that is you only put them on the line 9 times, so they're not getting points from driving the ball. And they're not in rebounding position. They only get 3 offensive rebounds. So when you give up some things, some made threes like we did, you gain some things in regard to rebounding opportunities and not putting them on the line. So overall, it's a good win. We're ecstatic to be 8-4. 4-0 in this little homestand we thought was very, very important to do. I thought our kids competed again for 40 minutes.
Yeah.
Well, you know, we told our guys for 3 or 4 days, look, they're the second best three-point shooting club in America. So don't be surprised when they shoot it from 26 feet. That's what they do. Don't be surprised when they shoot it off one pass. That's what they do. And we just didn't get to them. And it's hard to say, well, man, he's at 26 feet. But good players and good teams, if that's their strength, they play to it. And so we didn't execute early defensively. To their credit, they made some deep, tough shots. And but you have to be tough enough to weather the storm. And we've been through it all year to this point. And whether it's at, you know, the VCU game when we cut it to 8, we were tough then. Whether it's Kansas, we're down 13, we tie it up, we're tough then. You know, there's been in every game we've had to withstand a run or multiple runs. And tonight I thought we did a good job of staying composed, staying in the course, and eventually it won out.
Following up on what you said there, Coach, Rembert in the first half did 6 threes. I think the whole second half he only takes 1 shot behind
guard. Yeah, well, I didn't realize that. So he only took 1 3 the second half. He must have made it because he had 6 made threes. You know, I just think obviously our guys did a better job the second half, and maybe I don't want to put words in anybody's mouth, but again, our style of play wears some people down. They're not quite as fresh in the second half, and if he only got 2 shots off in the second half, that's to our kid's credit because he's a really good player. Well, he is, and again, you know, Armani's got a game that some people would say, well, it's not the prettiest, but he's my type of dude, and I've said that since I got the job. He's tough. He's competitive. He's going to take a charge like he did. He's going to keep a ball alive like he did. He's going to make that extra pass, and he's just growing and developing and getting more and more confident. I mean, anytime a guy can get 13, 12, and 7, I mean, that's a complete night against a good team, and I'm proud of Armani. He's a hard-headed dude at times like we all are, but I mean that in a good way because a lot of times his stubbornness makes him be better than probably he is in the statistics and the improvement is showing. Yeah, you know, sometimes like we go 1-4 out of the break and it's kind of a tight game at the time and he tries to drive it off one pass and travels. Well, that's probably not the time and place, but there's been so many times he's done that and made a nice play or drawn a foul. So you kind of got to take the good with the bad. And, you know, that's what I mean. And sometimes I've coached a lot of guys like that. they make themselves better, or they're more productive because they're confident and tough, and them thinking they maybe are a little better than they really are, they play to that level. And I think he's one of those guys. I don't think he's going to play the same way against Kentucky as he did tonight. Now, who knows if he gets 13 and 12, but he's going to have the same mindset, the same confidence level, no matter who we play. I think that's a huge credit to him. Well, I just think the biggest thing was, you know, let's get a good shot on the rim, make the extra pass. They were changing their defenses up from man to zone, and the bottom line, we drove the basketball and created some rebounding angles, and guys made great effort to keep it alive, get another shot, keep it alive, get another shot. And again, our conditioning, and I think you know, our stamina is pretty good in the second half. It has been all year, and maybe on that one possession there, that was pretty evident. Yeah, I thought that our team, for whatever reason, we worked all the last 3 days against mostly zone. We expected to play against 40 minutes of zone. Don't get me wrong, we worked a little man-to-man, but they opened the game in man-to-man, and we were almost unsure or on our heels a little bit, and then they make all the threes, and now we go to the other end, we look like a deer in headlights. And once we kind of settled in, made a couple buckets, caught our breath or collected our composure, we were fine. But you're right, the first 4 minutes, I think a lot of our offensive weakness or our lack of productivity was based on them scoring at the other end so quickly.
Coach Garrett gets 32 minutes on the bench today, scores 12 points. How crucial is it to get something out of it?
Well, no question. You know, Derek's a guy that we talk about. He's not a true post player. He's more what we call the skilled four man. But he did a nice job tonight of finishing a couple balls, staying aggressive. He gets 5 rebounds, 12 points, got to the foul line 3 times. And the thing with Derek, it's a mentality. When his mindset is being aggressive and not hesitant or reluctant to make the right play, he's a good player. You know, and if he had part of Armani's personality or mental makeup, then he'd be even better. But he's certainly improving, and he and I, we've got a good relationship. We talk a lot, and I don't sugarcoat anything with him, but he's the type of guy that wants to get better, is constantly asking what else he can do, and I thought he did some nice things tonight. Yeah, he again tonight, you look at his stat line, 2 rebounds, 4 assists, a steal. You know, 3 weeks ago, he didn't have maybe 2 rebounds and 4 assists on his entire 6 or 7-game stretch. And so now he's doing some other things. And as we talk about, now you get a little swagger and you make some shots. And I like Robert's mentality right now. He's aggressive. He's not being hesitant. He's not worried about making mistakes. This was his season high, if I'm not mistaken, 28 minutes. And I think he's just going to continue to get better and better. Well, I think, you know, offensively, it's going to be a work in progress, and I'm probably going to be saying that as late as the SEC tournament. That's just our team. We don't have a go-to post player. We don't have that true point guard to just make the game easy for everybody else. But with that being said, we shared the ball incredibly well tonight. 19 assists on 26 made baskets is a great ratio. So we're going to continue to improve at the offensive end. I think defensively we've done a nice job. You know, we've got to get better in our rotations and our press. And the half court, we're probably ahead of where we are in our full court defenses. So I like where we're at there. But we've just got to understand our margin of error is so small. We've got to continue to improve every day. If you would have said before the season, Steve, would you take 8-4? You know, my mentality is let's go be 12-0. But with the schedule we've had, 8-4 is pretty good with the least experienced team in our league.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I would agree with that. You know, I think early in the year, we really thought Kevin would be our point guard. And just kind of, you know, out of coincidence or luck, toward the end of a practice, one day Josh said, "Coach, let me run the point." I said, "Okay, that's fine." And he slid over there, and I could tell he kind of liked being at the point. And we rolled with it, you know. So when Josh is out, there's no doubt I have confidence in Kevin to come in and play that position. It's not his natural spot, just like it isn't Josh's. But he's tough with the ball. He's confident. You know, he has a swagger about him as well. And he's not going to shy away from those minutes at the point guard position at all. You know, there's a fine line, Rob. I'm one of those guys, I really, really hold my guys and challenge them defensively and blocking out. But offensively, I try not to harness them too much. I want them playing fast, and that, I don't mean shooting it quick. I mean just playing fast and aggressive and not thinking too much. So I really didn't say anything to him other than once or twice I thought he maybe could have given it up in the open floor a little bit sooner. But, you know, I'm going to let Josh play as 6 assists, 3 steals, 4 rebounds. You know, again, that's a pretty complete line. He's not going to be perfect every night. But I'm going to probably this year with Josh Richardson just try to stay out of his way and let him hoop. I'm sorry, could you say it one more? Yeah, and just matchup. You know, they basically go 4 out, Ben. And at X5 position, you're having to guard the corner, close out the corners a lot, as you saw. And that's a tough slide. It was a tough slide for Willie. He was late a couple times. I thought it'd be tough for Tariq to get there. So we played Derek a lot at the 5, and he was better at getting to the corners and getting that covered. You know, just sometimes that happens. I'm not down on Tariq. He's going to be a good player. He's just got to continue to plug away.
Thanks, Coach.
Okay, thank you, guys. Happy New Year.